Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Here I'm writing a book, One God, One Faith, and the chapter is 13, The Chosen People. They are the demonstration nation of the world, and we should appreciate their sacrifices for giving us the lessons in the moral laws, morality. So here it is, video number 5. Typical example of a person who was drunk with the old wine of letters was Saul, who later on became Apostle Paul. Saul was an ardent student of Rabbi Gamaliel, an old scholar of the scriptures. He obeyed the moral laws of Moses by the letters, and unlike the other Jews of flesh, he did perform acts in accordance with the moral laws of Moses. For devotion to Yahweh, he was leading a celibate life, and therefore there was no question of immorality with him. Now, Saul, you know, the word, the root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural men, boys, you know, which are 12 to 16 years old. They start the school and they are disciplined in the moral laws. So, they are once born. Jesus needs twice born laborers and workers. So that's why the people who are laborers and workers of Jesus, they are 25 plus, who are sensible, who are no more under the domination of their parents or anyone. That means they are solitary. If you are not solitary, then you can't serve Jesus. So laborers of Jesus, they are solitary, capable of entering the narrow gate leading to the vineyard of our Father. So Saul, being a disciple of Gamaliel, Gamaliel is a schoolmaster. So he did what his schoolmaster told him to do. So he was his slave. And Jesus set him free through the Damascus experience. I will come later. Thus Saul was morally sound and faithful to Yahweh, with great inclination towards our supernatural Father God. But he, being a disciple of Gamaliel, was made drunk, blind, with the old wine of letters. Because of his clean heart and devotion towards God, that Christ Jesus, came into his life and shook off his old wine of the letters through the Damascus miracle of lightning. The degree of blindness that the letters had caused in him towards spirit is best sensed or imagined through the thickness of the scales that came off his eyes. For Saul, it was a new birth in spirit, and therefore he changed his name from Saul, the once-born bound disciple of Rabbi Gamaliel, to Paul, the son of the Most High. So this changeover, when I will do the Matthew 19, I will tell you why he changed it, you know, and I will give you an example. More on changing his name would be explained in the exposition of Matthew 19, the parable of marriage and divorce, which is very much misunderstood. Taking into consideration the above, The present theologians of letters in the universities and colleges are doing great deal of damage or harm to the Christianity of Jesus by producing blind souls drunk with the old wine of letters of both the Old and the New Testament, and thus creating a far greater spiritual blindness. I call them Nanak, you know, the second coming of Jesus, called them super donkeys carrying holy books. Then that which St. Paul had experienced. And if you can realize that the Christ Jesus came into the world because the manly priests or the moral teachers in the name of Moses had become corrupt, Logo, Thomas Logo 102, Jesus said, "Woe to the Pharisees, for they are like a greedy dog sleeping in the manger. Synagogues of oxen, hard-working, honest people go to the synagogue to learn something which is spiritual food they want to have. But this greedy man, Rabbi, is sitting there like a dog, barking at them." You know, that's what, you know, when Jesus healed somebody, a woman, on Sabbath, then that rabbi said, you should have come on other day than Sabbath. I would have healed you." So such thing, you know, hypocrites, hardworking, honest people, for neither does he eat, cannot understand gospel, because he is working for money, as these dog-collar people are working today. They are the hirelings. They don't understand gospel because they are worse than those rabbis, dog, you know. That is why they have dog collar. Cannot understand gospel, nor does he let the oxen eat. Ordinary people who can understand gospel, he won't let them, because he himself doesn't know. Why should they know? They will start questioning him. Christ Jesus, being our living mediator between us and our supernatural Father God, through his word, not through prayer and fasting. Prayer and fasting are antichrist in Jesus. We do not stand in the need of any manly interposer, such as the present Pope, false fathers in the Orthodox Church, fathers, they are the duplicate of rabbis who are standing in the marketplaces, and people will address them father, and they are the father in those sense, you know. Bishops, etc., the reverends, they call themselves reverend, they don't know even the iota of gospel, the super hypocrites. We, being the children of light, are royal priests and royal kings of living God, of the living present. Then by comparing the present dead in letters, hireling clerics, with the corrupt and blind Pharisees and Sadducees in the name of Moses, you will come to the conclusion that the present clerics are far worse off than those blind guides of the blind, rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, as Jesus stated in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, that the arid spirit is the sacked temple priest who could not find another job. They were fit for nothing, no other job than priestlyhood again. So they enter the church of God, and they bring in the Jewish leaven, or the written Torah, which was forbidden. It's a deadly poison to the New Testament, So then they poisoned the church by asking the people to read the Torah, written Torah, stressing Daniel said so, Isaiah said so, and all that, you know, nonsense. And when the apostle used to come, then they would tell, hey, look, they are reading. They don't need you. Go away. So they throw the apostles away and they create utter darkness. Thus, the present clerics are the people who are worse off. All the drunk with old wine of letters, and therefore they are most incapable of taking the new wine of spirit on top of it. Thus, the best laborers of Christ Jesus are the ordinary working class people with inclination towards God, remembering that you cannot sell something that you have received free. His word is received free, and therefore it is to be preached free. You can't become a hireling. The act of receiving free and giving free is called a royal act. That is why we are called royal priests, because we preach freely, not take money. These are hireling, you know, in the churches. They are not royal priests. They are crook. Therefore, the present hireling clerics of Mammon are neither the royal priests called the Christ, nor they are the royal kings, in that they are mostly the greedy parasites, dogs of churches. They are dogs sitting in the manger, rabbis. Similarly, these dog collar priests are dogs in the churches who themselves don't know anything, and they don't want the people to know either. So they will shut their ears. So if I go and teach them, they will say, Gnostics are heretic. And that's it. Once they call the Gnostics are heretic, they don't want to know me. Parasite dogs of churches, which they have turned into the social clubs of Mammon. And that are nowhere near the serving and sharing communities of Christ Jesus. That were the first churches of God, onefold, headed by the Christ Jesus, one shepherd. So Jesus is the first, is one shepherd of our one fold of Church of God, Church of England, Baptist Church, this and that. They're all blind men defining an elephant. How can the one fold has so many names? One fold means one fold of Church of God, headed by Jesus. So here you are. So I will leave it here. And we will do next.